Hey, so check this out. We're in Lens right now looking at a kind cluster that I have set up locally. And I've got one service account in the default namespace, and I've got no secrets in the default namespace. What's going to happen when I come into VS Code here? I've got this service account definition. Great. Simple enough. Not a lot to see here. User type bot. I wonder if that's important. Well, I'm going to apply this service account, and let's come back into Lens and see what happened. We've got my service account created. That's cool. But if I look at secrets, whoa, audit bot token. I got a token based on that same service account without having to create it manually. How'd that happen? And once again, I'd like to thank Gianluca Mardente, one of the maintainers of Sveltos, who helped me put this video together. Well, it's because Sveltos comes with a built-in events framework. And what we can do is we can create event sources in YAML. This is a custom resource definition, CRD. And we can say, listen for the creation of things like services. And we can specify the different API that we want to listen on. So right now, this is a service with a V1 in the base Kubernetes API. And then we are also filtering to say, okay, does it match? Does it have specific labels that we want to listen to? And if it does, that's when we respond. So how do we respond? We create an event trigger. This is another CRD that's based in the V1 beta Project Sveltos API. Cool. And based on the event source and the clusters that we can say we're listening to this event source in, and this is the same way we do anything else in Sveltos, right? We have to label our clusters. If these match, right? If an event source is raised in a cluster that we're listening to, we'll apply different handlers, we'll apply different responses. In this case, we're applying a network policy config map. Let's see what it looked like when I created that service account just now. Well, you can see we've got my service account that we created here, right? Name audit bot, and that matches. If we come back into Lens, we can see the audit bot token corresponds to the audit bot service account. Great. Well, the source that we looked for here, let me get rid of my terminal. I'm using the Project Sveltos V1 beta API, and that's got a CRD event source. And I named this event source service account event source. Pretty straightforward, because it's looking for service accounts in the base Kubernetes API version 1. That matches the API that I'm passing in here, right? Version 1. And when a service account is created, we're going to make sure it matches this label filter saying user type must equal bot. Well, looking at the service account config I just created, yeah, user type is bot. So that's my event source. So now Sveltos knows to look, hey, this is an event source, watch for certain events, but where? Well, if we look at the event target, we can say there's a match label selector here to determine which clusters this is going to apply to, and it's those that have the labels managed by Sveltos. So, does the cluster we were just looking at have that label? Well, let's look at Lens and find out. Now I'm looking at my resource definitions, my custom resource definitions for my Sveltos management cluster. If I look at the events framework cluster that I've got set up here, I shrink this down a little bit, yep. Labels managed by Sveltos. So because I applied this label to this cluster here, this red one, right? The events framework cluster, I'm able to react every time a service account is created by applying the contents of this config map. Okay, so this config map, looking for it in the Project Sveltos namespace, is going to have a name bot SA token. Well, that's this one, bot SA token CM, right? And what I'm applying to create this secret is the contents of this key value pair, right? This is a multi-line string, standard YAML stuff. I'm creating a secret, and this is the cool part. Sveltos allows you to use templating when you're reacting to events. Back in my event source, we have this collect resources true option. What that does is it allows me to pull all the data from this event and apply it in this template. That's how I'm able to fill in this template tag dynamically. That's why when I created the AuditBot service account, the AuditBot token was automatically created. It dynamically looked for the name of the resource. How cool is that? So what else can you do with this? Well, you can enforce good practices, and I'm gonna come back into Lens and show you something you should never ever do. So here we are, I'm looking at the network policies tab of this kind cluster that I have set up, and you can see I have no network policies. You should never have no network policies. Always use network policies. Anyway, this is just for demo purposes. So if I look at my namespaces, I've got a bunch of namespaces, and I wanna create a policy. I wanna create an event trigger that says anytime a namespace is created, I'm going to automatically create a network policy for that namespace and just blanket default deny all ingress. Okay, so I want to come back into VS Code. And if I look at my policy that I'm going to create, right, this is it. This is the config map that has, that holds the configuration I'm going to apply in my event trigger. And this is it. It's straightforward. It's a network policy that says deny all ingress to whatever namespace, right, whatever namespace is being created. And if I look at my event source, this is where we're going to get really crazy. My event source, it's all the things that we've seen before, right? It's got a listener for namespaces in the base API v1. But instead of watching for specific labels directly, we can pass in Lua and we can write scripts that, as long as it adheres to this function evaluate, and it returns this object in Lua that has a matching Boolean and a message string, right? That's the expected function signature for this evaluate, right? It's gonna return that object. As long as it does that, we can go really crazy and write a bunch of Lua that can parse out all the different logic that we want to apply when filtering. Does this namespace automatically get an ingress? And with this, it's pretty straightforward. It's just looking for the labels that we've seen before, right? In this case, access is private, right? That's the key value pair. That's the label pair that I'm going to be looking for to apply this ingress. But if you really wanted to, you could go nuts with this Lua and script it however you want. You could do a random generator that determines, hey, maybe we'll randomly apply and live on the edge. We're not going to do that. Anyway, now that we've got our event source and we're using Lua to determine what are we going to apply this to, here's my event trigger. And this is just like the other one that we saw. It's going to apply a config map. This config map's name is Lockdown Network Policy CM, and that matches here. Cool. And it's going to be applied in the cluster managed by Sveltos. So that's the one that we're working with. So I'm going to come into my terminal, kubectl, apply F, target YAMLs, and this one is going to be the namespace. I'm calling this one accounting namespace. So let's come back into Lens real quick, right? We don't see an accounting namespace, right? These are the namespaces we see. And again, we don't have any network policies. So I'm going to, in VS Code, I'm going to apply this. And look at namespaces, there's accounting, look at network policies. Wait for it, it'll get there. There it is, accounting network policy. And this is going to have the exact same, let's shrink this down a little bit. This is gonna have the exact same configuration that we saw before, policy type ingress. So now you're probably thinking, hey, that's cool and all, but you just created a bunch of orphaned resources. We don't even have YAMLs for those resources. Nothing's tracking them to make sure that, hey, when the service account gets deleted, the token gets deleted, or when the namespace gets deleted, the network policy gets deleted. That's a problem. Well, fun thing is, Sveltos actually keeps track of those relationships and it listens for the deletion event and cleans up all the orphaned resources. So watch. Back in terminal, back in VS Code, I'm going to kubectl delete that audit bot. And if I come back into Lens and I look at my secrets, where are you? Secrets in the default namespace, the token is gone. If I look for, where's my access, my service accounts, the service account is gone. So let me do the same thing with my namespace, right? I'm going to kubectl delete f target YAMLs namespace accounting. And I'll look for my network policy. And that's gone. That just got deleted. And where's my namespaces? Namespace is gone too. Sveltos is cleaning up after itself. Whenever it sees a new resource created, it creates the corresponding resources based on those event triggers. But it also listens for the deletion event, and it cleans up those resources based on the triggers that you set. How cool is that? And even cooler, you can create chained resources, or you can create resources in a different cluster from where the event happened. This is one of the coolest features I've ever seen in an open source cloud native project. This is mind-blowing what you can do with this. Maybe you have an Argo CD deployment in your management cluster, and when an application gets created, you create a bunch of stuff somewhere else. Maybe you want to mimic, or you want to mirror one cluster to another. Any resources that are created in one cluster, you're going to create in another cluster. There is so much you can do with this. So if you want to see more complex use cases, drop a comment. I am open to suggestions, and I'm clearly excited about what you can do with Sveltos. If you like this video, please consider dropping a like. And if you want to see more videos like it, please consider subscribing. Thanks for watching.